Now with just about 2 weeks and 9 housemates left, struggling for the top position in the Big Brother Naija lockdown house. Hello guys, what's up? Trickity, how you doing? Laycon as your deputy, because as far as you were concerned, if any other person won in that house, they wouldn't pick you as a deputy.
Everybody had like favorites, close people, you know, and I don't think I saw anybody are close, apart from maybe Kibaya.
Would you say, in your opinion, that you guys were entertaining this past week? You had fun in the jacuzzi. You also have fun eating. Doesn't mean it's entertaining.
No. If me personally having fun is not entertaining, then yeah, maybe we were not entertaining then.
So, the nominated housemates, would you please stand? Prince! You... have been evicted. You look amazing too. I don't believe that. Was it also that made you move on, or what did she say or do that made you move on?
First of all, when I came into the house, I didn't want to get into any relationship at all. But this.
Let's talk about Dorothy.
I love Dorothy like a sister. She's like a sister to me. We've been friends ever since like the week one.
What's Tolani Bash for you going forward?
I feel like we have scores to settle, so when we settle the scores, we can talk about that. So yeah, there's a few things you have to say to me first. So let me just say this in front of the whole world. People can want you to be my mentor. So I want to go into hosting, acting as well, agriculture. Definitely open a salon.
Dorothy, what's up?
I've been myself, but I'm just not somebody to actually talk about other people's business.
It's about the fact that it might be a push and pull between you and Benji.
Yo, great personality. We've got similarities in our personalities. That's probably why people think that we have something going on. Because like, I can tell you now, I don't see her in that way whatsoever. Like, we're just friends, literally, that's it. Like,
that on a few occasions, you pretty much proposed what I would call marriage to Nengi.
I feel like it's just been the same way since our very first conversation.
The next housemate to be evicted from the Big Brother Naija lockdown house. Kidwai. Are you really happy to be here? To be out here?
Definitely.
Why?
The gym. I miss outside life, I miss my people. I miss getting like business done. Like, for me, I feel like now that I'm out, it's straight to work. I think money was never really my motivation going there. I wanted to go because I wanted to try something new.
Then you gave the politically correct answer in there about Nengi.
Nengi, I'm not attracted to her at all. We literally write together, we have no conversations, we dance together, we drink together. That's all it's ever been. My point of view, there's no physical or sexual attraction to Nengi at all. She's just cool. Erica, she's more than a friend, man. She's someone that I feel, when I'm around, I feel safe. I feel like I can be myself. I feel like she's really got my back. What it is, yeah, I don't know if it's going to be a relationship or just friendship. But I know that she's someone I definitely want to keep in my life.
Hey guys, welcome back to yet another exciting video from the Amazon Deb. Today's video is the eviction show of the Big Brother Nigeria lockdown edition. If you are not subscribed already, please do well by clicking the subscribe button and join the Tad family. Without further ado, let's get started with today's video. Hello guys, today is the 7th eviction, live eviction show of the Big Brother Nigeria lockdown. And you know, Ebuka looking all nice and all, you know, dressed up as, you know, usual. Ebuka crossed in into the house to, you know, question the house, and he starts by asking the HOH Tricky T. Guys, if you've not watched the video of how Tricky T won this HOH, guys, I have a video ready. Do yourself a favor and go and watch it, okay? So, Ebuka asked him about her. You know, his reign, and you know, why he picked Laycon as his deputy head of house. And he had said that because, you know, and yeah, Trickity did say that, oh, he picked Laycon because out of every other person, if those people had won HOH, they wouldn't have picked him, which was actually legit and whatnot. So Trickity, you know, confirmed it and said yes, because everybody had someone that they were close to already in the house. So he kind of just surveyed it and just knew that none of them would have picked him if he was HOH. So he decided to pick Laycon. But yeah, we move. Lekan also was then asked, you know, if he found this week to be entertaining. Lekan was like, oh yes, he found it to be entertaining and whatnot, but like during the jacuzzi when they are eating and whatnot, but then Lekan then went on to say the fact that maybe because of what their wager, you know, told them to do. For instance, their wager was like, it has to be a peaceful week, so perhaps maybe that is why it seemed that it wasn't fun. And it did kind of make sense anyways, but even with their wager, I think there was still a little bit drama, so I don't know where Ebuka was bringing that question from. Anyway, Ebuka went on to the business of today, and Prince was the first person to be evicted today. Guys, you know, it's not a shocker to me anyways. I said, okay, Mr. Nigeria, it's okay. Anyways, he came onto the stage, and Ebuka asked him, you know, how was he feeling? He said he was feeling fine, that he saw it coming and all, and because, you know, he had just, and if we had seen the dress he wore and whatnot, like, he had always had it, but he just knew that he never brought it out or wore it, and but he bringing it to them because he knew it was going. I'm like, okay. Then Ebuka asked him, you know, what, you know, he felt he didn't win and whatnot. So it was like, yes, he felt, you know, he was really passionate to win HOH and also to win the Darling Tax, and that he is so close, but with the fact that it's out now, Tricky T might win that. And guys, I hope Darling is able to help, like, give him a compensation prize, because guy didn't do well. Every Saturday he was always beautifying the ladies and even the men. He did absolutely well. Then Ebuka asked him concerning himself and Nengi and whatnot, and you know, the way he answered the whole question, he said, me, I don't understand. I'm like, okay, diplomatic, okay, it's okay. Then Ebuka went on to ask him concerning Dorothy, and he said, yes, he loves Dorothy as his sister and whatnot. So, guys, they are just on that level. And that they have even been close this first week, which, yeah, it was actually true. When Ebuka played the clip of those that nominated him, he was surprised with Tricky T. He knew people saw him as a competition, hence why he wasn't even surprised that most of them nominated him, but he was surprised about Tricky T. Then Ebuka asked him about Tolani Badge, what's next with him and Tolani Badge, and they were like, oh, he and Tolani Badge has a score to settle, and when, you know, they meet, Tolani Badge has something to say to him, and they will see how it goes from there. Only God knows what's between these two people. But guys, what do you think? Is it gonna work? Anyways, let's move on. Ebuka then asked him, oh, so what's next for him? And he goes on to say, Ebuka, in front of everybody, I want to ask you to be my mentor. I said, what? Oh my God, this guy is so good. Like, nah, fam, that's just the best one. Like, and Ebuka was like, oh, you're putting me on the spot. Okay, what exactly do you want to do after the house? And he goes on to say he wants to do acting, hosting, agriculture, and saloon. Guys, he said he wants to own a saloon. I mean, like, yes. And before he went, Ebuka was like, you know what? I've got your back. I said, yes. Ebuka then went back into the house and he asked more questions, and instead of with, you know, Dorothy keeps mentioning his name and saying Ebuka and friends and whatnot, is she, you know, not trying to be herself on the show, or is she always just being conscious that, you know, she's being watched? And she said, oh no, that the fact is that she doesn't even like discussing other people's business, that if she has anything, something to say about someone, she would go to the person, but whereby she needs to then discuss the person with another person, it's not in her nature, not in her character. That's why she doesn't engage in it. And she was like, oh yes, and also, you know, when she talks about Ebuka, it's also because she also wants to escape Ebuka's question on Sundays. I'm like, okay, I don't like Dorothy is not in a bad thing, but you know, my fave, okay. Then Ebuka went on to ask Kid Wire concerning Nengi's situation and, you know, what people have said concerning he and Nengi. And Kid Wire was like, you know what, Nengi is a good chick. He's cool with Nengi. They are friends and that's on period. Ebuka then moved on to Ozo, that, you know, you have been proposing to her and whatnot, that, you know, what's going on. And then Ozo came and said, oh, that they had a conversation yesterday, and, you know, so yeah, moving on, it's not going to be, you know, proposing back, or, you know, moving on with Nengi and, you know, the proposing thing, because Nengi had cleared him that she had somebody outside. But like, guy, chill with this nonsense you are saying. She has been telling you for how many weeks she has somebody outside. So why are you telling us that the one she said yesterday is the one you take serious? I wear a joke to you. Show no man. Anyways, then Ebuka then announced that it was, you know, evicting the next person, and the next person evicted was Kid Wire. Guys, see, this today eviction do me somehow. Actually, Kid Wire was evicted, and when Kid Wire got to the stage, Ebuka asked him how he felt. He was like, oh, he's good, you know, he did want to go and whatnot, and he has missed the gym and whatnot. Then Ebuka said, oh, and he did, other interviews and the other things Ebuka asked him, he said, you know, money was not the motivation for him. He just wanted to come and experience it, connect with people, and, you know, make connection, and that was just it. And he just wanted the connection, and he came, he got it, and he's good about it. Then Ebuka went on to ask him concerning the issue that, you know, about Nengi, that he should elaborate what he said while he was in the house concerning Nengi. And Kid Wire cleared everybody. Kid Wire was like, see, I'm not attracted to Nengi, okay? Saying, you know, he's not attracted to Nengi. Nengi is just a cool chick. They are just friends, and that's on period, and they just have the same vibe, and that's why they were always vibing together, and that was it. Ebuka went on to ask Kid Wire concerning Erica, and I was like, yeah, he feels safe with Erica. He knows Erica is his girl. Like, Erica has got his back, and he definitely needs Erica in his space. And I was like, he doesn't know if they're going to be friends or lovers, but Erica would definitely be in his space and whatnot, either as friend or lover. But he's going to see how it goes. Like, now that they're in the real life, that's when, you know, the test of the relationship is going to know which one is going to be. But he definitely has got Erica on his side. It's okay, nice one. And that was it. And okay, Ebuka asked him what next for him. He said, first is eating the gym. Like, he needs his mentality to be back. Like, his mental, you know, he wants, you know, his mentality. Okay, guys, I'm mixing this English. Anyways, he then said he would also have to speak to his mentor, his mom, his dad, his team, and so he would know what's up. And guys, that was it. And Ebuka then came back into the house. He went on to ask Nengi concerning what Ozo has said, if she feels Ozo is going to change. And Nengi said, no, she doesn't feel he's going to change, you know, due to, as a result of what the excuse, you know, Ozo gave. And yeah, I feel you, sis. I don't think it's gonna change, because it's not like it's yesterday you are just telling him that you have somebody outside. You've been telling him ever since. So why is it gonna behave like yesterday's conversation is the greatest for him? It's gonna enter his head. But guys, that was it, Sha. Guys, let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Guys, I'm not really happy with today's eviction, you know, Kid going. I thought Ozo was going to go. I'm actually tired of the nonsense Ozo is doing in the house, you know, he and this old Nengi situation. I'm tired of seeing it. And guys, almost seeming that the house is dull, no drama whatsoever. Now there are like 7 of them left in the house, and they're all doing friendship, and it's annoying me. I didn't pay for all of this friendship nonsense. I didn't pay for all of that. I paid for drama. I paid to watch this thing for drama and the content. Like, what's all of this? You all are doing your own friends and what's not. I don't get it. But guys, I will still be bringing the taste to you. Tomorrow is nomination. Let me see what they are going to who they are going to nominate and whatnot. But guys, anyways, I'm happy Dora is still in the house at the end of the day. But I don't know about Ozo. But anyways, guys, it's not like I hate Ozo, but I'm just tired of this old E and Nengi situation. If this week he really stops doing this Nengi situation thing, then definitely I'm ready to see more of him in the house. But guys, that's my thoughts on today's eviction show. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section, guys. You know how we do it. Comment down there. If you are not subscribed, please remember to hit the subscribe button to join this family, the Ted family. You know how we do it. And remember to like this video, give this video big thumbs up, share this video with loved ones. Thank you for watching. Have a beautiful week. Until my next video, guys, stay blessed.